Handicapper Steve here, handicapping the racing from Churchill Downs here on Thursday. It is November the 1st, 2018. Gonna look at the featured ninth race from Churchill, but before I get on to that, remember to please follow me on Twitter at HorseRacingKid5 for more selections for race courses around the world. Also, join me tomorrow for my Breeders' Cup preview video. That should be up, tomorrow, hopefully, for Friday's card, and Saturday's card should be up, I want to say, Thursday evening, Friday morning. The latest, so those should be up very soon, but first we have to get through Thursday's card from Churchill, and I'm going to look at the featured ninth race, which is a good stakes race, so let's get on to it. The ninth race from Churchill, it's the Bet on Sunshine Stakes, purse $100,000, this race is for three-year-olds and upwards, field of seven horses going to post, a distance of ground of 1,200 meters, or the distance of ground of six furlongs on the main track, which will probably be wet. 1,200 meters, 6 furlongs on the wet Churchill main dirt track. A lot of rain going into Louisville on Wednesday into Thursday, so Thursday's card, you'll probably see some wet conditions on the main track. This weekend, you'll probably see a wet turf course, but the track, Churchill's notorious for drying very quickly, the main track, so I wouldn't, it will be fast most likely this weekend unless we get more showers. But today's card, I did handicap this race for a wet going. My top selection, I like the 3-horse Heartwood. I'm going to go 3-2-5-1 in the superfecta. 3-2-5-1 super. My top selection, the 3-horse Heartwood. This 4-year-old colt by Tappet, Tyler Gaffalione, coming off of a great Keeneland meeting last month, is riding this one for James Chapman. The horse's most recent outing came the 5th of October at Keeneland. 6 rungs in the Grade 2 Phoenix. The horse finished 4th by 3.25 lengths there, and he just never had the good closing kick. Didn't break all that well. Just couldn't keep up with those better horses. Promises Fulfilled's running tomorrow, this weekend in the sprint, along with Whitmore and Limousine Liberal. He just couldn't keep up with them. I think, like I said, step down in class, he should really run a lot better against these quality horses. There's also a lot of speed in this race, which I think will play up to a closer if there's a pace meltdown, and I think this horse can close if he wants to. Before the Phoenix, this horse ran Saratoga, 7 furlongs in the Grade 1 Forgo. The horse finished 6th by 3.75 lengths. That day he set the pace, and then he just hit the wall around the turn. He just couldn't keep up against Grade 1 horses. It wasn't, again, the day to win. And then a Mountaineer, 6 furlongs and a 75,000 overnight stakes on West Virginia Derby Day. The horse won by neck. He sat back early after not the best of trips, but he got there in Indiana. Good race. And then before that, at Thistle, 6 furlongs off to 25 claimer. He won by 1/4 lengths. Stalked early on. Didn't break all that well, but had a great turn of foot. He has, he has experience on a wet course. Most recent wet course he ran on was at Pimlico, 6 furlongs on the slop in the Maryland Grade 3 Maryland Sprint, where he finished 5th by 9.75 lengths. He broke horribly, like he normally does, but he just wasn't gaining any ground. That week at Pimlico, Preakness week, horses were not closing up. The speed was king that weekend with the sloppy going, and this horse just couldn't change the bias. And then before that, this horse ran at here at Churchill on Derby Day in a 1-mile optional 100 claimer. That could have been a Grade 1 race. McCracken won. This horse just never got into it. And then before that, Keeneland on the slop in April and a 6-furlong optional 100 claimer. Horse won by 1.5 lengths at 14-1. He just had a great turn of foot after some fast fractions in front of him. I expect him to run similar to the way he ran on the 15th of April at Keeneland. And if there's a pace meltdown, I think he'd get a piece of it. So I'll use him as a top selection. I'll use him on a multi race, along with the 2-horse Switzerland. I know he's the favorite, but I think if he could go by the lead by himself, I think he'd get away with it. This Steve Aspin trained 4-year-old colt by Spicetown, who's best to be remembered as winning the 2004 Breeders' Cup Sprint at Lone Star in very fast time. Ricardo Santana Jr.'s on this one. Can't speak today, pardon me. Can't hear either. I have a slight ear infection, but that's for a different subject. But, this Switzerland, his most recent outing came the DeFrancis Dash at Laurel a few weeks ago, 3/4 of a mile on the 22nd of September. That day, the horse went by 2.75 lengths on lead all throughout. This horse just had a very easy victory. Before then, the Vanderbilt at Saratoga, 6 furlongs, July 28th. The horse just couldn't keep up those graded horses. He finished 5th, never got into the good closing kick at the end. It wasn't the day to win, and probably his best race today, I think, came in the Maryland Sprint at Pimlico, 6 furlongs on the 19th of May. The horse won by 3.5 lengths on lead all throughout. He just had a very good going away victory. He loved every bit of the slop. On a sloppy going, he's 5-3. He's made most of his money there, so if there's a way he get the lead by himself, I think he'd get away with it. At 4-5, he's a horse I'll definitely use in my multi-race ticket, pick 4, pick 3, whatever I decide to play, but to recap my selections now for the ninth from Churchill. It's the bet on Sunshine Stakes. Gonna go with the 3-horse Heartwood as top selection. I also used a 2-horse Switzerland in a multi-race wager. I'm gonna go 3-2-5-1 in the superfecta. That's the top four, basically. So good luck to all, and please follow me on Twitter at horseracingkit5. Good luck, everybody.